Hey, in this one I wanted to show you what Docker multi-stage builds are and how you can save, reduce the size of your Docker images by quite a bit, which is very useful when you want to, well, deploy them anywhere. Like for example, in CI/CD, you spawn multiple jobs that have that download your Docker image, or just in production, you want to spawn a lot of them. If each time it has to download it and it's like 5 gigs, it's you have to wait a long time depending on your network bandwidth, and it's just also just waste. So yeah, there's a neat trick for that, and I'm gonna show it today. So you can see here I have a little C file that just prints hello and prints something according to a macro, nothing fancy. And I also have a Docker file, which is basically the Ubuntu image. I install GCC in it, I copy my main, I change my working directory, I compile the main, and I set the executable as my entry point. Nothing fancy. I can build it with the tag my main and then run it like so. And you see it just works as you'd expect. The problem is, well, for now it's not a problem because it's a very small file, but if I get the size of this Docker image, it's 300 megabytes already, and I just have like basically no code, no libraries whatsoever. And you might think, oh yeah, that's just the price of using Docker images, but there is ways to make it way smaller. And so that's where multi-stage builds come in, because currently in my Docker images, I have the full Ubuntu image, but I also have this. So I have GCC, which is obviously not needed when you run your executable. And I also have apt-update, which downloaded the repositories of packages from Ubuntu, and obviously I don't need that at runtime. So this can be discarded. And what you can do is you can have multiple from in your Docker file, which will declare multiple stages. And you can have, for let's say the first one, I will name it build, because this is where I build my stuff. And the second one, I will name it runtime, because this is, yeah, where I'm gonna run the thing. And what you can do is you can copy a file from a previous stage into your current stage. Let me show you. You can just use from like this equal build. So this is just the name of your of the previous stage. And then you just pick the file as usual. And so here I'm just copying the executable, which I named main, into the second stage. And so what this will do is that you can you basically have two containers in one Docker file now, and yeah, by default it will pick the last one. So now if I build it and run it, still the exact same thing, but now if I get the size, you see that it's all, yeah, it's dropped by a lot, almost less than a third of what it was before. And so yeah, that's awesome. One small, you have to be careful with this, because of course, if you have libraries which use shared objects and so on, you also have to copy the shared object into your runtime container. And so often what people do is you just build a static executable, meaning that all your libraries are contained into the one executable and there is no other files on which you depend. And for that on GCC, you can just use the static thing. Which in our case makes no difference, but you can still do it, or like you should do it to avoid headaches. Next, I can quickly show you that for example here I'm depending on Ubuntu, but I could depend on, because like obviously my executable is not 78 megabytes. This is mostly Ubuntu stuff. And you could depend on other images, like let's say Debian, but that's not really recommended, like because yeah, for example, the C and C++ standard library is kind of in common between those, and then you can do it. It just gets a bit tricky. So you could use Alpine here if you want, but if you do that, I would recommend trying to build with Alpine as well, you know, to avoid unnecessary headaches. And if you're really into saving like as much as possible, and you want like the most bare bone images for your runtime so that you can just download it just like that, and basically you're just downloading the executable at that point, there is a special Docker image called Scratch. And this is the image from which the Ubuntu image or the Debian image depend themselves. You know, if you want to create a Docker image for your own distribution, this is usually what you use, I assume. And so you can have this. And I think yeah, with the static, it's just it will build and run. I think it still works, but this time you can see that the size is less than 1 meg. Which is probably basically the size of my executable, almost. So yeah, that's a neat trick. I don't really use this in real life because like sometimes it's handy to just have a shell because like you have literally nothing. It's just your executable here. So most of the time it's actually kind of handy to just actually have a shell and basic commands to debug stuff maybe if something goes very, very wrong or something like that. But yeah, it can be useful sometimes. Next, I can show you how you're not limited to two stages. You can actually have as many as you want. And so what I used recently, I used this recently at work to have a runtime image that is a debug version of the executable and a runtime image that is the release version of the executable. And the way I do it is that I have a... So the GCC command will be different for those. This is in common. And so you can also depend, your from can use the previous stages. So you could do from build as build debug, like so. And this will just compile with debug. And I can declare the debug variable because my executable uses it. And I can have a build release, like so, which in this case will not define debug and will optimize the thing. And next, I can have my my runtime debug, and like so, which will copy from the image build debug, and this has an entry point the same, this is the entry point the same, and I will have my debug release, which copies the executable, but from build release. And so in this case, you can see that I'll be able to have two images and two different build stage and so on. So let's try that up. Forgot to mention that now it's a bit confusing as which one is actually getting built on the tag I selected, but you can say target get is equal to runtime debug because here I declare I want this stage to be at this tag, and it will build this. And so now if I run my main, you can see that it's the debug build, but if I pick the release target, now we will see that we are using the release build, and still the image size should be extremely small since I'm using Scratch. So yep, that's about everything I had to say about multi-stage build. I hope it will help you. And yeah, a couple of instances where I use this at work. For example, a few days ago, I created a Docker image for a relatively large C++ program. And the initial like image that was just one Docker image was, I think, 4 gigs in size because it has a lot of dependencies and stuff like that. But the I think the runtime image is, yeah, I forgot. I think half a gig or something or a bit less. And I depended on Ubuntu, not Scratch. I think in another instance, again, at previous work, I had a Docker image which was horrendously large at like 10 gigs or whatever because we were doing strange things. And yeah, part of it was removing some useless files or being a bit smarter during the build. But I think I saved also like 5 gigs or 3 gigs easily with multi-stage builds in that case. So yeah, it can come in quite handy, especially since in that instance we had like a very bad network bandwidth between yeah where we build the image and where we need to ship it. So yeah, it was taking yeah on a if the thing wasn't cached before, it was literally taking I think like easily 30 minutes to download, which was horrendous. So yeah, this helped a lot. And yeah, anyway, it's just nice a nice cool trick that Docker can do. I hope you enjoyed it, and yeah, see you on the next one.